A massive amount of evidence just released in the hazing death investigation of a FAMU drum major. Good evening. I'm Martha Sagowski.
I'm Jim Payne. Our newsroom has been carefully sifting through thousands of pages of documents.
Now, those pages reveal a brutal beating at the hands of fellow band members. We have recorded statements from witnesses and a detailed account of what happened on a band bus last November in Orlando. We're also getting reaction from the victim's family.
We have team coverage tonight. WESH 2's Gail Pascal Brown shows us what Robert Champion's parents have to say. But we start with Amanda over here live in the studio. Amanda?
Well, I have here a diagram that was drawn by one of the suspects charged in Robert Champion's death. It shows the placement of band members on the bus the night Champion tried to fight his way through a tunnel of beating fists and kicking feet. It was a hazing ritual so brutal, it claimed his life.
Documents released in the beating death of FAMU drum major Robert Champion contain new and disturbing information. One band member claims when some of the upperclassmen learned Champion had died, they wanted to remove their fingerprints from his body.
After they found out Robert wasn't moving, the upperclassmen that initiated the hazing went around the hotel asking for alcohol to rub down his body and take out their fingerprints.
Another band member told detectives before the band left Tallahassee to travel to Orlando, the band director and a local police chief gave them a stern lecture about the dangers of hazing.
They were saying hazing is against the law, and that you shouldn't do it, and it's bad, and it'll destroy the band, and you can get charged for hazing.
As for the details of Champion's beating, it was part of a hazing ritual called crossing over. The goal is to walk the length of the bus aisle while being beaten by other band members who not only hit and kick the victim, but use a strap. Champion made it to the back of the bus, but then collapsed and died of blunt force trauma. One of two other band members hazed that same night said he vomited after his beating, and when it was Champion's turn, Champion was fearful.
He really didn't want to do it, but he was kind of like, I'm just going to do it. You know, I told him, I said, if you don't want to do it, don't do it.
Why did you do it?
Honestly, I did it for the same reason that everybody else do it, just to get the respect.
The investigative report reveals that even though only a select few people knew about it, Robert Champion had been pegged to be the next head drum major. One of the suspects charged in the case claims Champion had been asking him all year to go through with the hazing ritual because he wanted to earn the honor. I'll have more on that coming up on WESH 2 News at 6.